मेरा गांव घर डुमरी पड़ता है। यहाँ दीदी आलू रोपते हैं, टमाटर रोपते हैं और मिर्च भी लगाते हैं, और हम VRP के माध्यम से दीदी को तकनीकी बताते हैं। जो दीदी तकनीकों को पहले नहीं जानती थी, और तकनीकी के जानकारी होते हुए किसान का जैसे 1 रुपया खाद लाते थे, 4 आना के खाद लाते हैं और 12 आना बचा रहे हैं और अपने बच्चे के अच्छा स्कूल में भेज रहे हैं।
The government of India launched a program called the National Rural Livelihood Mission, which is one of the world's largest poverty reduction programs. And basically, their focus is to empower rural communities by organizing them into groups of women who share and learn with one another, and also building a huge force of community-level resource persons.
Digital Green uses video by the local community featuring local people and disseminated by somebody from the same village. And this whole approach is becoming increasingly part of the National Rural Livelihood Mission. The traditional way of reaching out to the community was through one-on-one interaction, and that was time-consuming. The messaging was also not very consistent. Now, with the video, they're able to have consistency in messages. The people who feature in the videos are from close to them, and they can identify with them. That creates a huge impact.
क्योंकि आज भी वो मुझे refer करके बता सकती हैं कि दीदी वो video में तो हमने ऐसा देखा था, और वो practical है। जब पिछड़ा weeding करना था उस time, तो वो practical experiences जो था, वो video में हम लोगों ने दीदी लोन खुद capture की थी।
The Digital Green approach has been institutionalized at the district level within the state rural livelihood missions with a group of community resource persons, and they are trained to be able to produce these videos. They work alongside the livelihood specialists of our partners, the state rural livelihood missions, who provide backstopping support to make sure that the technical content that is represented in the videos that they finally produce and edit is consistent and complete.
By adopting the technology of the DG, our staff, their knowledge has been improved.
लेकिन जब डिस्ट्रिक्ट इनके इंटरवेंशन उन्हें जुड़ा तो हम लोग एक सिस्टम बना जिसके अनुसार हम लोग एक कितने मेंबर्स हमारे वीडियोस को वो देख रहे हैं, कितने मेंबर्स हमारे इस चीज़ों को फॉलो कर रहे हैं, और देखने के बाद कितने दीदी लोगों ने उस चीज़ों पर अडोप्ट किया, ये भी एक फॉर्मेट हम लोग का एडोप्शन आते थे।
Digital Green has become part of the planning process. How they're making commitment to provide staff, to train staff, to procure equipment, to make it happen.
Already we had a very good established system of community resource persons. And these community resource persons now are being given additional training into handling these Pico projectors.
These village resource persons were trained through group training types of sessions and orientations, but they were quite variable and limited. Now what's happening is that our team, together with the National Rural Livelihood Missions team, both at the national and state levels, use the videos that are getting produced to be able, in a practical way, train these individuals on subjects like the agriculture, health, or nutrition practice, and also the tools of how to use a Pico projector and how to also record data and feedback from the communities that they're working with.
The Digital Green platform is now a part of Jivika's extension strategy. Once we realize the efficacy of this medium, in all our plannings, we incorporated this as a very potent tool.
तो वीडियो को बारे में हम लोग पहले कम जानकारी था, ऐसे लोग करते थे, तो अब वीडियो को माध्यम से लोगों में बहुत जागरूक फैल गया है, बहुत महिला जागरूक हो गया और अपने पति को बतलाते हैं तो वो भी बहुत जागरूक हो गया, उसे बहुत लाभ मिला है और आगे बढ़ने का भी बहुत मौका मिला है वीडियो के तहत से।
Technology is a means to improve the extension services manifold. It actually makes communities hope, aspire for something different from what their current status is.
What you have done is basically you have changed the way the knowledge is created and disseminated. So this digital exchange and video creation is now a way of life. I think this is a revolution waiting to happen. And once that happens,
then you will see so many practices and technologies being used by millions of farmers all over the world.